Hello everyone and welcome to Warhammer Online Return of Reckoning on the private server. Today we're going to be looking at what do we do in the game when we're here. So if you're watching this tutorial, that means you already chosen your realm, you have chosen your race, you have chosen your class, you went through the process of creating your character, maybe you have fixed your interface, play with your add-ons, and you're ready to move forward in this world. Now before we move forward, we need to learn a few terms and how some mechanics work. The first thing we need to learn is that this game has two different levels. The first level is the career rank, which is equivalent to any type of level you know in any other game, which you level up by getting experience. You have one bar with the experience points. Now, experience you gain by doing anything in this game. Killing NPCs, doing quests, public quests, PvP, anything gives you experience. It is the easiest one to level up, and the maximum level is 40. The second leveling tier, if you like, is the renown points, also known as simply RR with the initial renown rank. This is something you gain only when you PvP, whether that is scenarios, which is the equivalent of battlegrounds in other games, or in open field PvP, taking keeps, forts, anything that's PvP related. This one is a little bit harder to obtain because you have to PvP, and the maximum level at the moment is 80. Now, a lot of people consider this game to be 99.9% PvP, but the game also has a lot of PvE involved. So once you get into the game, you can do you can follow three paths. One is the PvE path, which means you can go out and do quests, public quests, kill mobs and explore the whole world. You don't have to step into PvP if you don't want to. However, some of the gear and weapons, they require you to have a certain level of renown to use them. So that might become a little bit of a problem, but it is not necessary, I repeat, not necessary to do PvP if you don't want to. The second path, if you like, is to do 100% PvP. So you don't have to do any PvE at all, because remember, you get your renown rank and your XP only by doing PvP activities. And the third is a mixture of PvE and PvP, which is what I like to do. Now, when you start off, if you check your bag, you will start with a horse, but it requires you to be rank 2. That means you have to be level 2 to do it. So what I tend to do is start with a few quests here on the starting area in order to get some money. That money will help us to move around the map by using the flight points, and in the same time start with some scenarios to start grinding in my renown rank. The quests on this game, they don't have those wonderful exclamation mark and question marks above the heads of people. They have the little book. So green is a quest, blue is a repeatable quest, and orange is the one you have completed. The quests here work like in any other game. You right click to interact with the NPC, you pick up the quest, you read it, you accept it. This one only gives XP. And then this is where we need to deliver this one. You can see becomes orange. Now on your mini map, if you look down here on the right, you can see there's a red little area around that shows you the general vicinity of where you need to do the quest or deliver the quest. It's the basic mechanics you find in all MMORPGs. However, because this is a private server and still a few things are under development, been corrected, sometimes the NPCs will not have the little book above the heads. Personally, I have not found many, but it's there, so you might have to actually click them in order to find the quest. So you move to the next one, you pick up the quest. The interface is quite simple. You can either use your mouse to click or the numbers as in anything. So this is PvE, and we can keep on going like this. You know, this is level 1, of course, is easy. You can loot the corpse like anything else. Just need to kill people. There's a quest tracker as well here on the right. Need to kill one more. No, that's not the right one. Oh, it is. There we go. Always loot at the beginning. You can set up a button for auto loot as well. Oh, there's another player there. So we done this quest. The quest is not hard in this game. Most people end up doing a couple of them on end game to acquire some weapons for the looks. So we already went to rank 2 and the game automatically gives you your skills. You don't need to go to a trainer or anything like that. So as you can see now that I level up, I got my next spell, which is a firebomb. Just gonna put it on number 2, it's convenient for me. You lock the bar so you can move things. And the only thing you need to go to trainers for is when you level up and you reach level 10, but we'll do a different tutorial for that, how you make your builds and everything. I'll run through you when the character goes to level 10 as well. And also when it's time for you to get your renown. Renown is used from the PvP levels to increase your statistics, your health, your resistances, you know, your tank statistics and everything. That starts after level 10. Now, we said you can do PvP from level 1, and that is true, although we're level 2, but if you click this icon down here, join scenario queue, you have a list of scenarios, and you can join all of them, and you can keep on PvEing until one of those scenarios pop up, and you can join it. I will show you in a different tutorial how scenarios and all that work. Now, here we are on the quest part. I don't think I picked up the other one. Yep, I didn't. So, doing the quest and killing, we managed to get some copper here. So, just gonna pick up the next one as well.
Looks like rain again.
Just to have it. Just pick someone, there is a quest. While we're waiting for the scenario to pop, for example, I will direct you back to the minimap on the bottom right. You can see the red indication where the quest is.
There you are.
I'm just going to complete that. I don't want to pick up the next one myself. So this is the map. We start down here. Now, if you like PvE, you can move along the dotted lines and then to the main road. And you can pick up all the quests you can find through that. As you go up, and you will notice on the map here, we have some chest boxes, treasure chest boxes. These ones indicate public quest. For example, this one is a normal public quest, means the difficulty is normal. It's for levels 1 to 2, normal rewards, and is designed to be done by 6 to 9 players. And currently, no one is doing it. That means that if you go near this area, and we will go there, you will automatically pick up the quest, and you and anybody else who is around the area, you can play together and finish the quest. At the end of the quest, the rewards are split according to who put more effort, you know, who did the most damage, who did most heal, and so on. And you can keep on doing that and level up. There's plenty of public quests around the map, as you can see, I'm showing you here. And you can go on like this. Personally, I don't like PvE too much. I find it to be a refreshing break from PvP, but I personally do not focus on it too much. So, the other thing you can do is PvP. This up here with the locks is a PvP area. Every tier 1, 2, 3, and 4, they have their own PvP maps and campaigns. And those campaigns, if you zoom out a little bit on the map, you can see them. Tier 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there's one map on this. And we have the different regions as well. The Dwarf versus Greenskins, Empire, High Elves. And that's it. Land of the Dead is not in the game yet. And all this progress from tier 1, you lock it, then you go to tier 2, tier 3, tier 4, and then you go to the fort and the city sieges, which is the end game at the moment. Now, in order to get to the PvP area, okay, so you kill a few mobs, you get your mount, you queue for scenarios for the PvP aspect of it, and then you want to go here. The fastest way to do that, and that is the same for both realms, you need to run to chapter 2. Down here there is a flight guy and you can use it to get the quicker, or you just follow the road. And this is what we call open RVR, and the scenarios is just scenarios. Now these are the paths for you to take and mix them up any way you want, play the style you want. Now PvP wise, if you go to an open area, it will show you how many people are there. You can join different parties. People have the parties open so other people can join, and then if there's more than six people, it can be converted into a warband that can hold up to 24 people, that they become one huge party. And that's how you move on from tier 1 all the way to tier 4 at the end game, by doing quests, public quests, PvP in the open areas, the scenarios. Now, there is a small difference between scenarios and open RVR. Some people ask whether I should do both or not. You could do both. You could do only one. Usually, if, let's say you play a tank, your main spec would be a tank. So if you do open RVR, the big maps, you will get your gear for your tanking, your defensive. However, since you can play the tanks as a two-handed DPS as well, that gear is usually found in the scenarios. And some of the weapons there are quite good. So you have to look into it and mix and match a little bit. Now, I'm talking a little bit, trying to get to the main one. This is the PvP area. At the moment it's locked, it's not active. But once you get into the first war camp here, and I say again, this goes the same for the destruction side as well. The first thing you need to do or want to do is find this guy here, the rally master. And you can set your rally point. Yes. Now, once you do that, if you are stuck somewhere, you need to come here quickly. You can use your Book of Binding and it will bring you here. You can pick up more PvP quests from the NPCs around. There's one here, there's one there. And also, these are the important vendors with the pouches above the heads. Right, see, this guy is renown gear. So this one requires renown 4 and level 7. So you need XP level 7, PvP level 4 to use it. You can buy your gear here from scenarios and that. And this is safe. No one can attack you here. As you can see, my name is grayed out. As I said, this zone is locked, but I will show you. So if you want to go into the PvP, you leave your war camp, you go into the PvP area. Now, as soon as I go in here, as you can see, my HP dropped because it made me level 16. So the game trying to keep everything equal, so it made me level 16. It increased my statistics, my HP, so I can play. Your skills are the same, your statistics have increased. Now my name is yellow, so my PvP is active, and this is where all the fun on the PvP begins. And I'm going to leave it at this. There will be another tutorial later on to explain how PvP works, what the objectives, and how we move around into it. I think that for now, this tutorial covers what you need to know, how to get started, how to join scenarios, how to do public quests, where to find them, and how to get a move on in this world. I hope you find all this information useful to help you ease in into the game. And always remember, you can always use the advice channel in your chat to ask questions.